Hey, this is Tony with Salt Strong, and we recently just had a question come in from one of our members about transferring GPS coordinates from Google Earth or Google Maps to your actual GPS unit on your vessel. Now, the issue he was running into was the format of the coordinates taken from Google Maps or Google Earth was different than the format that you would have to input on the actual GPS unit. So I want to talk about that in this video. Now, first off, just to give you an idea of some different formats that GPS coordinates will come in, as you can see here, you have degrees, minutes, and seconds, and then you have degrees and decimal minutes, and then you have decimal degrees. Now, when you're pulling coordinates from Google Maps or Google Earth, they're either going to be in degrees, minutes, and seconds, or they're going to be in decimal degrees. And typically, what you're going to input into your GPS unit is going to be in degrees and decimal minutes. So you have to convert those numbers over in order to put them into your unit and pretty much get the exact spot that you're trying to look for. So going back to Google Maps, let's just say for an example, you're trying to get to this spot right here, this deeper area. You basically go to the map, hold the cursor over and hold the button onto the cursor and then release. And then as you can see, you're going to get some coordinates right down here. And these are in decimal degrees. When you click on that, a pin's going to drop down and then you're going to have some more coordinates over here. This bigger number right here, this is in degrees, minutes, and seconds. And then again, that smaller number right down there is in decimal degrees. And like I said, these two numbers typically are not what you're going to put into your GPS unit. You're typically going to put the degrees and decimal minutes in, and you have to convert that. So there is a website. I'll have a link down below. If you're watching this video on YouTube, be sure to go to our main website, to the actual blog post for this video, and you'll see a link to this converter. But this is it right here. And as you can see, it has those three different formats for GPS coordinates. And you would basically just put either the decimal degrees, which is right here, or you can put in the degrees, minutes, and seconds from Google Earth or Google Maps, and that's going to give you the degrees and decimal minutes that you would input into your actual unit on your vessel. Now, I use a Simrad Go series, and it has to be in degrees, decimal minutes when you input it. So let's just take an example. This spot that we showed right here, how to convert that. You would basically just take those coordinates, either one, input it into the converter. So let's go ahead and do that now. Latitude 28, 12, then 46.4. And then make sure you're on north. Longitude 80 degrees. And then 37 minutes and 57.3 seconds, and make sure that's set to west. And there you go, it has converted it to degrees, decimal minutes, and also decimal degrees over here. And this number right here, that's what I would be putting into my GPS unit on my vessel. Now lastly, one last issue you may come across is that your actual GPS unit may not accept all of these values. Like for an example, there's four numbers here after the decimal. If it only accepts three, just put those three in. If it only accepts two, just put those two in. Some GPS machines are more accurate, so they'll accept more numbers. And if they're not as accurate, they may accept less numbers. So it's not too big of a deal. It's not going to throw you off too far. It'll still get you into that general location. So hopefully this video can help you out if you are trying to convert those different formats to input them into your GPS unit. All units are different. They may accept different formats, so you really have to just figure out, you know, which one does it accept. And you can just look at the number itself. Look at the numbers. If it looks like that, that's obviously what you're going to put into your GPS. If it looks like this, that's what you're going to be putting into your GPS. And then just convert it and input it accordingly. So if you have any questions about this or any additional tips you would like to share, definitely let us know down below. Until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.
Hey there, it's Joe Simons, one of the co-founders here at Salt Strong. And have you claimed your free pack of these irresistible Slam Shady Paddle Tail lures? We designed this lure with over 12,000 serious inshore anglers, including many full-time guides, to go out there and catch more redfish, more speckled trout, more snook, more flounder, more inshore saltwater slams. And if you want a free pack to try out a sample yourself, click down below right now. We have one free pack per angler while supplies last. Click down below right now.